Baja, California. Understandably, it's known for its dry, remote desert landscape that over the years has turned back armies and tested the best off-road vehicles with its ruggedness. Today, over 40% of those living here are transplanted from the US or Europe to enjoy the good life in this tropical playground that contains much more life than you might expect. Effort to explore the countryside, you'll find forests of unusual indigenous white trees and elephant trees, and over the next ridge might be an oasis with mango orchards and some of the most massive trees in North America. And along the Sea of Cortez, a freshwater estuary creates a marsh that's home to an incredible variety of wetland birds that are both out of place and at home in this desert wetland paradise. But it's the sea that draws so many to Baja, a sea fed by nutrient-rich cold water that feeds an amazing chain of life. And occasionally, you get to see what actually lives at the top of the food chain. And quite often, if you keep your eyes open, you'll catch a 200-pound striped marlin free jumping above the horizon, because it can. The East Cape of Baja is famous for its excellent striped marlin fishing, and the lure of hooking and fighting these beautiful fish brings thousands of anglers to this area every year. But most do not just fish for marlin. The East Cape is an amazing fishery filled with all kinds of game fish, including sailfish, tuna, dorado, wahoo, and roosterfish, just waiting to take your bait. This week, we're fishing out of the Hotel Punta Colorada on the East Cape of Baja for a spectacular multi-species experience with Roy Clark and Mike Rieser and Mary Waugh of the Baja Fly Fishing Company. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. The Hotel Punta Colorada is a fisherman's oasis, a remote, quiet, comfortable place to call home while experiencing the tremendous fishing found on the East Cape. Roy Clark, who runs Clark's Outdoor Sporting Adventures, has been fishing and bringing groups to the East Cape for over 30 years, and this year's no exception. The morning greets us with a rare, distant July rainstorm over this unique body of water that's known for playing mind games. And on some mornings, you might think that besides the pelicans, this water is void of life, but you'd be wrong. This episode is brought to you in part by the California Department of Boating and Waterways, Shasta Tackle Company, Max Lure, and Max High Definition Sunglasses. Setting on a remote piece of East Cape beachfront, the Hotel Punta Colorada is known around the world as the roosterfish capital of the world, with its rocky shoreline holding a huge population of roosterfish. But today, we're with Roy Clark as he heads offshore with Mike Rieser and Mary Waugh of the Baja Fly Fishing Company, who specialize not only in fly fishing for roosterfish, but also the many other species of game fish found swimming together in these waters, including billfish, tuna, wahoo, and dorado. Before we'd even reached where we thought we'd find fish, Roy found himself fighting this big bull dorado. Dorado can often be found in large schools, but it's not unusual to find big bulls cruising the open water as loners or in small groups. Mike and Mary tried to tease up other dorado in the area, but this fish turned out to be a loner. Dorado, also known as mahi-mahi, are among the fastest growing fish in the ocean, and these East Cape dorado grow fast on a steady diet of flying fish, squid, and mackerel, and tend to grow larger than those found around Hawaii or Florida. Besides being great fun to fight on a fly rod, we now have some excellent eating fillets on board. Just another mile or two out, we find a buoy that's holding bait, and usually where there's bait, there's fish. The only question is, what kind of fish?
Oh, I got broke off, that's what happened.
Here. 9 feet,
2 feet. 2 teeth, huh?
Maybe tuna.
Yeah.
No, big farmer.
No smart. Mucho ranchero.
We're out about 30 miles out on the shark buoy south of Punta Colorada, and there's a bunch of tuna on the bite right here, right now. All these shark buoys out here are holding fish. This is where all the bait are. That's the whole thing about it.
What we thought might be yellowfin tuna turned out to be skipjack.
Blue marlin bait.
A smaller, hard-fighting cousin that makes an excellent fly rod fish, and also an excellent marlin bait.
Put it in a tuna tube.
Just in case. A school of fish like this means non-stop hookups, and there's always the possibility that something much bigger will grab your fly.
Another skipjack.
Roy, I got this one fishing dead drop with the clouser, just casting out, let it sink down through, and then first strip, they hit, and it's a real effective way on all of your tuna family, whether it's skipjack or yellowfin.
Cool.
And I'm not sure.
That might be a better fish, eh?
I'm getting a pretty good throb. I might have to go up to the upper handle here.
Oh, caramba. Dang nabbit. He whacked it, see that?
Good school size skipping.
That's a bigger skipjack.
You know, the nice thing about skipjack, they can really make a day on a fly rod. Fish this size, it's just perfect for fly rod kind of fun. And that's one of the nice things about down here in Sea of Cortez. You never know when you pull up on a school of feeding fish, whether it's going to be yellowfin, skipjack, bonita, dorado. We pulled amberjack up in situations like this. Every once in a while, a sail or a marlin will come through, and here we are with the light rod, make a presentation to it, and get a hookup.
All the way to the backing plus. Hope Mike's got a lot of backing on this reel.
Right there.
Skippy. Thought it was tuna.
This episode of Angler West TV is brought to you in part by Procure Bait Sense, P-Line, Neil's Master Lures of Finland, and Van Warmer Resorts. Welcome back to the East Cape of Baja. I'm Justin Wolf. Roy Clark and Mike Rieser and Mary Waugh of Baja Fly Fishing Company are wearing their arms out on skipjack. But now it's time to make a move to find what else swims in these waters.
But out here we could encounter anything. Skipjack, a lot of fun on the fly rod. Very similar to playing a yellowfin tuna, very strong fish. I'm sure that we'll get into yellowfin before the day's over. Dorado, good shot at sails, and striped marlin. All that's right out here close together. If one species isn't working, we can always go to alternative B, C, or D.
Tuna, there's a tuna right there. Oh, he whacked it, I got him. Fish on, double. Aye. Oh, you got one coming on you again, Mary. Coming on you again.
We've seen tuna flashing on the surface. We won't know till we get them up. This fish went straight down, which is more like a tuna. Could be a skipjack. The two fight a lot alike. Although the tuna tends to go to the down foot.
Tuna, right here, yellow, see? These polarized glasses are the best to use for little confused. You can really tell. I seen that fish down at probably 30 feet, and I could tell it was a tuna, not a skipjack. If you didn't have your glasses on, you didn't know where to do that. Yeah, you seen the gap, you know, like, uh-oh. Okay.
There are skipjack in this area, but also yellowfin tuna, which are prized as a food fish. These are small football-sized tuna, which can still challenge a fly rod, and yellowfin over 100 pounds are often caught around here, so be careful what you ask for.
Yeah. Oh, look, look. Shark or something. Yeah, shark hit it.
We're using 12 weight rods. And these are saltwater designed for fighting and playing heavy fish. Our leaders are 20 pound, and we're using P-Line FluoroClear. It's a nice hybrid of nylon and fluorocarbon. I like it because of the it's got a softer inner core, which makes a much better cinch down on your knots. Absolutely critical in these fish that you have good knots. And I don't like a real brittle, hard line. And P-Line is, we've tested a lot of different products, and we find excellent in terms of knot strength, suppleness, which equates to better motion of the fly in the water. And the flies we're using are predominantly clousers. We can cast them and let them dead drop, which is deadly on all the tunas. Or we can strip it fast on the surface, and it swims in a very stable fashion because of the design of the fly.
Sorry, Mary.
Don't know what got on here. It could be yellowfin, it could be a skipjack, it could be a bonita. Pretty much eliminated. It's not dorado because it hasn't jumped. That's the beauty about it down here. You just don't know from one fish, from one cast to the next, what species you're going to hook. And we've been constantly tripled up.
Yeah.
Almost the entire morning. Here's the fly that we're using, the Clouser Minnow. Very good dead drop fly. And also, too, if we want to strip it fast on the surface, it's stable because of these nice heavy heads. It's not going to turn and roll when we give a real hard strip or sweep on the fly to get it up to speed necessary to catch these fish. The knot I'm using is 100% loop knot, also known as the lefty's loop. A very good strong knot and allows the fly to swing on that leader.
It wasn't out there 2 seconds, bam! You don't ever want to get your hands next to that handle. called a knuckle buster. Talk about 250 yards of line out. I've been fighting this fish for about a, close to a half hour. We don't know what it is. We don't, if the dorado's usually jump. He hasn't jumped, hasn't showed himself. And it's not fighting like a tuna. The tuna usually sound, and he's staying way out. He took over 300 yards of line out already. We're kind of chasing him right now with a boat. We have no idea what it is. See you later. I can't do anything with this fish. It owns me.
Today's episode of Angler West TV is brought to you in part by Qualicum River's Winter Harbor Resort, Dove Island Lodge, the Boomerang Tool Company, and Coldwell Banker CNC Properties.
He's swimming with us.
Roy Clark has his hands full with something big that took his fly nearly 45 minutes ago while he was casting to football-sized tuna. Now it's time to find out what's pulling on the end of his line.
See you, Mike?
I mean, hit it.
That's him? I got him? No way. I got a marlin on. Unbelievable. Huh? That's that fly you gave me. Oh, easy, easy, easy. Come at me. I got him. Okay, okay. Woo! Unbelievable. We lost him. Probably what happened is he probably got the bill. Cut him off.
Yeah, because we don't have a heavy leader on there.
Unbelievable. We got sawed off. We didn't have a big leader on. We got bill wrapped.
Yeah, what happened back here, just like we were talking about earlier, all the different species that occur down here, you never know when you get into a bust what's going to show up. And what happened to Roy, he was set up for tuna, and we don't like a real heavy leader on tuna because it dampens the action on the fly, whereas, and he just hooked up with a billfish, and they have a real rough bill, and what we normally have on billfish is 80 or 100 pound P-line fluoroclear bite leader. That we didn't have on there because it's not really good for tuna, and when that marlin started jumping, he got his bill up and wrapped into the 20-pound leader that we're using for tuna and cut him off. That's why we have this 100-pound attached to this fly, so that when that billfish gets up there and jumps, he doesn't wrap that leader, or if he does wrap the leader around his bill, that 100-pound will take the abrasion and we can keep the fish on.
If you want to target marlin on a fly, then Mike and Mary are definitely the ones you want to fish with. Visit their website or contact Roy Clark for more information. And if you stay at the Hotel Punta Colorada, be sure not to miss the Mexican buffet night, where it's an awesome all-you-can-eat Mexican gourmet meal. Another place to find great food is at the Hotel Palmas de Cortez, just about a half-hour boat ride from Punta Colorada. Palmas de Cortez is a beautiful resort in the town of Los Perillas. Every year, dozens of billfish tournaments are held out of Palmas de Cortez. And this year, it's the 10th annual Roy Clark Billfish Tournament.
That one's not eating squid.
No, that one's eating ballyhoo. He came up and hit that bleeding mackerel lure.
Yeah.
And I threw the bait on him and he ate it. That's what we like to see, him hungry.
This year, I had the honor of fishing the tournament with Roy, which meant 4 days of fighting fish and some tired arms, but all well worth it. In this tournament, each marlin caught and released is worth 100 points, with sailfish being worth 75 and tuna and dorado worth 1 point per pound for every pound over 20 pounds.
Another 100 points, Justin. How about that, huh?
How about that?
Top dog today.
The bait and switch technique can work well, but often these marlin will hit trolled lures. After over 30 years of fishing these waters, Roy has refined his lure selection, and for the most part, uses lures by Eat Me Lures exclusively. Having the right colors, head styles, and skirt action all contribute to a lure's effectiveness. And after years of trial and error and hundreds of billfish caught, Roy has a whole lot of confidence in his lure selections. For more information about Eat Me Lures, visit eatmelures.com or contact Roy. And also, ask about the Roy Clark Signature Collection, which will eliminate the guesswork about which lures to bring to the East Cape. Those fishing the Roy Clark Billfish Tournament this year experienced some tremendous battles with a wide variety of species besides striped marlin. And if you're interested in fishing next year's tournament, then contact Roy Clark today. These tournaments are all about having fun with some serious fishing in a beautiful place, but space is limited, so don't wait too long to call. And also ask Roy about his upcoming roosterfish tournament, which means fishing out of tangas for world-class roosterfish in the roosterfish capital of the world. And for more information on Punta Colorada, Palmas de Cortez, and the other Van Warmer resorts, visit vanwarmerresorts.com today.
Thanks for watching today's episode of Angler West TV. You know, it's only with the sponsor support that the show is made possible, so please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.